Via Degli Dei is a trail in Italy that is 130 kilometers long. It connects the cities of Bologna in the region of Emilia-Romagna and Firenze in the region of Toscana. On its way, it crosses the Apennine Mountains, which are like a backbone of Italian peninsula. This was my first long-distance trek, and because I recently became interested in long-distance walking, I slowly acquired the gear and equipment and then started planning my first trek. I chose the month of April because I could take a few days off. I started preparations about 1 month before. I did a few long day treks, about 30 kilometers each, just to train my joints and muscles a little bit. So for the start of the hike, I was quite well prepared. I arrived in the city of Bologna by train at 9 o'clock in the morning, ready to start my hike.
Piazza Maggiore, Via degli Dei, official start. It's 10 o'clock in the morning. 0 kilometers done. Let's go in that direction. This is supposed to be the longest hallway in Italy, about 4 kilometers. Looking for a panini or something similar. The first ascending part has begun.
After the 4 kilometer hallway, which is strangely made of exactly 666 arches, on the top of the hill there is the San Luca Monastery. It was Easter Monday, so the area was full of people. Near the monastery I had a nice snack, spianata con prosciutto crudo, and then I was ready to continue.
These are the first meters of forest path. Up until now there was asphalt and city roads. Very nice. Now that we are out of the town of Bologna and out of the people, we can do a little chit-chat and commentary about how the first part of the via was. As you can see, the weather is gorgeous today. Sunny weather. And for the next 2 days, it should remain like this. And then we should have a day of rain. Hopefully, not too much rain, but we'll see. I have my rain gear with me. The first part of the trip from the Bologna station to the monastery of San Luca was a little tricky for navigation because there are no indications for route number 112 or Via Degli Dei. This is the Italian name of this route. The way of gods, or the path of gods, would be in English. So the first part was a little bit tricky, but I have my guide in the PDF on the telephone, so it was not that much of a problem. There was about 300 meters of ascending. It's Easter Monday, so there was quite a lot of people. The longest hallway in Italy was very crowded, but after the monastery of San Luca, the number of people has diminished. We did 10 kilometers, me and my backpack. We had a nice lunch, pause in between. I bought some piadina con prosciutto crudo. I ate that, spent 15 euros, and now we continue. Trail angels spotted. Now this is a big walnut plantation. There must be over a few hundred walnuts here. Oh man, very nice. Now this is a nice view of the Reno River. After 1 hour, so the slow Apenninic ascending has begun. I've been on the ascent for about half an hour now, and our goal today is Mount Monte Adone. It's 3 o'clock right now, and the sun sets at 8 p.m. so we have 5 hours left to conquer this mountain. Let's go. All these persons doing picnics here because it's Easter Monday. There is like a few hundred people here. Now this is a nice resting spot. Have been resting here for half an hour. I took a hard-earned break after 23 kilometers. So right now I'll eat a snack or something and then I'll keep on going. I have 5 more kilometers to do today. So no time to lose. Very beautiful. This part of Via degli Dei is extra beautiful. We are between the Badolo and Monte Adone. Beautiful forest path. Very nice. I hope the whole way will look like this. Passo del Monte di Frate, 530 meters above sea level. And finally, we have reached Monte Adone with a very, very majestic view on the Reno Valley. View from Monte Adone. First day, first camp. The tent is ready. The place is called Brento. Right. Now we must prepare the dinner. So the first day has been really interesting. Yesterday evening when I came into the camp, I found out that I didn't bring my full gas. So now I have to or buy alcohol and make a stove out of the beer or find a new gas tank somewhere. Leaving Brento. Now a long piece of asphalt road is awaiting us, I think 9 kilometers. So yeah, about last night, went into camp and found out that I have no gas. Been asking fellow campers if they maybe have a spare gas bottle. One lent me a gas bottle just for the dinner, but they didn't have gas bottles to sell me. So today I have to or buy a new gas bottle or make an alcohol stove and buy one. Anyway, our next goal is a village called Monzuno, about 9 kilometers from here. So about 9 kilometers of asphalt road is awaiting us. The weather, as you can see, is perfect. It's 9 o'clock in the morning and yeah, in the morning I took my time to
put everything inside the backpack and did a little chit chat with fellow campers, made breakfast with hot water from from the tap. I just mixed a bag of dehydrated food with some hot water that was running from the tap. So yeah, it was interesting. And now we continue. So this one is Monte Adone from yesterday. And this is our Via degli Dei, today's edition. I thought that the road will be asphalt, as the guide said, but it turned into a quite nice forest path. A little bit up, a little bit down, but as you can see, it's quite gorgeous. Back on asphalt. Monte Adone, goodbye. Here we can see for the first time remains of a Roman road, Via Flaminia Militare. The name was Via Flaminia. It was used for connection of Rome and Bologna and the Pianura Padana, the region of northern Italy. Oh yes. Interesting how Roman roads last 2000 years. Our modern roads last like 5 years. And then they're full of holes. It's 11 o'clock and we arrived in Monzuno. Now I must check if they have any gas bottles. Hopefully they do. And do a few resupplies in the market. Let's go. Arrived in Monzuno. Ate a sandwich. Now I have to refill the water and continue that way. So, few updates. We just left Monzuno, which is here. And I didn't find any gas. They didn't have any gas. So I have a gas bottle that is almost empty. And I think that in one cooking, it would be empty. So I have to be smart about what I use it for. The next village is Madonna dei Fornelli. It's about 10 kilometers from here. I think I'll need about 3 to 4 hours because there is quite a bit of ascending, as you can see. This is all uphill. So I think I'll need about 4 hours. I'll definitely stop in between and have a snack or have a drink or something. But down there in Monzuno, there was a supermarket with a very nice young lady which made a panini for me, a sandwich. I took a very large sandwich, so I took some calories for today. And in the next village, I'll have a pizza or something. I hope they will have something. For now, let's continue. I'll take a shot of the view so you can imagine how it looks like. Nice Apennine hills. And beautiful weather today. I hope it lasts. Just another shot of beautiful Via degli Dei forest. I'm on a crest of the mountain. I don't know how it's called, but it's above Monzuno. You can see the vegetation here on the northern side is not as developed as before, but it's quite nice. I've seen a few hikers. In 1 hour time, I've seen 3 or 4 people on the trail, so it's quite popular. Very nice route here. I reached the top. I think it's Monte Venere, but Maybe I'm wrong, somebody correct me if I'm wrong. Admiring the views of the Apennines and the Alpi Apuane, the Apuan Alps in the distance. I already see Toscana. Now I just have to reach it. Too bad that there are cameras there. I think it's military tower or something like that. If there wouldn't be any cameras, I would definitely climb it. But with cameras, I don't want to risk it. I don't want to go to jail today. Took a few minutes, ate a snack, and now just chilling in the sun, enjoying the view. I have 5 kilometers until Madonna dei Fornelli, so I'll have a lunch there. Let's get going. I can assure you that the wind is blowing, without a doubt. The biggest irony of all is that I'm walking on the gas line all the way. There is a gas line. Gas line, and I have no gas. There is a gas line and I have no gas. Oh no. We arrived in Madonna dei Fornelli. Nice village. Now we have to ask for the gas and take a little break and then continue. I'm leaving now. It's a beautiful place, but unfortunately no gas for me. That means that I'll have to eat cold or find another solution in the next village, which is called Pian di Balestra. The signs say 1.5 hours of walking, so it should be around five kilometers. Let's go. The pine trees are slowly starting to appear, which means that we are getting higher. But the houses here and the look all around is very, very nice. This is one of the nicest segments of the road so far, between Madonna dei Fornelli and Pian di Balestra. It's quite an uphill, but we are doing it. There is absolutely no mobile network here. Interesting. This path just keep going uphill and uphill. And this is how the top of Apenninic mountain looks like. I'm on a wide road and I'm in a pine forest. Very nice, very picturesque. Welcome to my second night. Today we sleep here in Pian di Balestra. 1,000 meters above the sea level. And so begins the third day of our journey. The sleep was okay. It was around 5 degrees Celsius. It wasn't too cold. I was comfortable in my sleeping bags. In the beginning of the night, there was a little bit of wind, but then the wind calmed and the only problem now in the morning was a little bit of condensation on the tent, but I wiped it off with a towel. The housekeepers were very, very generous. They offered a bathroom, they did a breakfast, everything was perfect here, so I couldn't thank them enough. And right now I'm returning on the trail, which is up here on this crest. the weather, it is what it is. A little bit of humidity and a little bit of clouds, but today it should be rainless. So let's see. I didn't find any gas, and I'm now I'm without the power bank too. It died yesterday, so I have to rely on huts and bars to keep my cell phone alive from now. I returned on Via degli Dei, and now we continue. Next station is Santa Agata, 10 kilometers from here or so. Let's go. So we left Emilia Romagna. Bye bye Emilia Romagna. And we are entering Toscana region. Let's go. I'm walking on the remains of the road that is 1,900 years old. Crazy. Monte Bastione is the name of the place. This is today's view of the Toscana region. The weather is a little bit of humidity in the air. And so the descending begins. Descent to Sant'Agata. Beautiful lake. I think it's used for fishing, maybe. Because the water is not really clear and drinkable. And I came from over there. Banditace. This is the top of this pass, which goes, the road goes down to Passo della Futa, which is my next goal. The weather is cloudy, but no rain. Let's hope it remains this way. Such a beautiful day. And even if there is a little bit of fog above me, I feel so happy to be immersed in this beautiful nature for the third day already. It's like being in paradise. I've been walking mostly on my own, like 90% of the time, and the people that I've met have been very kind and very open and generous, as Italians are in general. They are beautiful people, and I absolutely love the place and its people. So when I was in the city of Bologna, I was a little bit nervous because of the quantity of people and the city stress that was present all around. But now, for more than 2 days, I'm immersed in these beautiful forests, and for the most time I'm alone. And this feels absolutely beautiful, really. Via degli Dei in month of April, up until now, has been super. Italians would say bellissimo. Military cemetery on the Passo della Futa pass. Sad it's closed for public. Nice walk on the ridge. There is forest on both sides, but the walk is beautiful. All the trees are without leaves for now. This is one of the pieces of the path that reminds me of Alpine world, with all the cables to hold and everything. Quite steep, but nothing too difficult. Water source. Time to refill our bottles. We lost approximately 200 meters of elevation, and you can tell from the vegetation. The trees here are a little bit greener. I must admit, it's a lot nicer to walk in an environment that is greener. Heading towards Santa Agata. The sign says 2 hours. Let's go. Descend for quite some time now. I think I'm descending for about an hour and a half now. And I must say, it's difficult. I did already more than 20 kilometers without proper food, so it's not the easiest day. Today altogether I must do a little bit less than 35 kilometers. Okay, a bit of ascent here, but it won't be easy. My legs feel heavy already after 20 kilometers the third day. Can't wait to come into Santa Agata village to take something for lunch. And then I have 7 more kilometers to reach San Piero a Sieve. The villages are in the Sieve Valley, the valley where the river Sieve flows. And let's go. Now that's a nice welcome to Toscana. Beautiful. Lunch in Santa Agata. San Piero a Sieve, finally. After 35 kilometers, finally in San Piero di Sieve. I will not make many films because I don't have much battery left, so I have to get to camping as soon as possible and put the phone to charge. In the meantime, I have 2 more kilometers or so. So we reached this beautiful abandoned fortress. There is absolutely nobody except for me. My backpack. I think I'll set camp up here underneath these trees here to have some shelter from the rain, which is set to begin this night. It should rain all night and today all day and tomorrow all day, so I'll seek some shelter here and do a overnight bivouac in the tent. It's 6:30 right now and it's been raining all night. There is a little bit of condensation, nothing too scary. But yeah, today will be raining all day. posto davvero bellissimo. Water. Trebbiano, ciao ciao. Fortunately no rain, but a lot of humidity. We are soaked. My tent is 2 kilograms instead of 1 kilo full of water. Walking towards the top of Monte Senario. Monte Senario Mountain. This uphill was the most difficult part of this journey, but not because of the uphill. The elevation that we had to do was 600 meters, but because of wet equipment that I have in my backpack and wet floor, shoes are a lot heavier than yesterday because of all the mud and because of the humidity in the air, which makes you sweat like crazy. And all added together makes for one hell of a difficult ascent.
After that difficult and humid incline, we finally reached a nice pine forest, which accompanied us until the village of Bivigliano, where our walk ended for that day. On the way I met two wonderful hikers, Alberto and Deborah, and we walked pretty much the whole rest of the trip together. In the evening we went for a well-deserved and delicious dinner with a few fellow hikers.
Friday, the last day. The weather says rain. We are covered with our ponchos. 22 kilometers to Firenze. Sto facendo un po' di video per avere la memoria dove abbiamo camminato. So, a few updates. For the past 2 hours we've been walking in rain. We are covered in water, as you can see. So yesterday and today were rainy, but this is the risk that we knew of when we chose to start our journey in April. So now we are arriving in a place called Le Croci. And then we have a little bit of uphill and then downhill towards Fiesole and then finally Firenze. So we have about 19 kilometers left. The landscape here is amazing. Without the rain it would be even more amazing, but already now it's super nice. So happy to be in Toscana again. So this was the last uphill of Via degli Dei. The peak behind me, the hill, is called Poggio Pratone. And from now on, only descend until Fiesole and then Firenze. Beautiful. Even if it rains, I feel much better than yesterday. We are approaching the goal, so yes. As you can see, this path is full of mud, but my feet are not wet. I feel a little bit of humidity, of course, but I'm not wet, I'm not soaked. And I have merino socks on me, so everything is at it, as it should be. We can see Firenze, we can see Firenze, kind of, but they are over here in the fog and in the rain in the distance.
Soon we spotted some road signs for Firenze, which meant that we are getting close. After about 1 hour of nice and easy descent, we arrived in the town of Fiesole, where we had a much needed coffee and a few snacks. We could already see the city of Firenze from a beautiful viewpoint.
Firenze, buongiorno. Bellissimo, eh? Yay! Firenze, ragazzi!
Vamos!
Vamos!
And so we officially entered the city of Firenze. It took us about another 45 minutes to reach the city center. Despite the rainy weather, we were very happy to have achieved our goal. Now we just had to reach the official end of the trail, the Piazza della Signoria Square, but on the way we of course had to stop and see the magnificent Duomo di Firenze Cathedral.
Piazza Duomo, ragazzi, Piazza Duomo! Ecco, Piazza della Signoria. This is the end of our Via degli Dei, Firenze. we made it. Yes. Another one?
Grande.
Yeah.